traumatic macular hole may present in different ways. In this case of large traumatic macular hole, PVD happened leaving a central part behind. Trauma sometimes causes firm adhesion between posterior vitreous, ILM and retinal layers. For staining, I use soft tip. First, I take in the dye within the soft tip by suction and inject it slowly by proportional reflex mode. It gives me opportunity to go much closer to retina and stain it in a very controlled way. Complications related to jet flow can be avoided by this way. Started peeling from a stained area, but after some time it seems some retinal layer is coming with it. So, started from another side, but same thing was happening. Tried all over the area, actually they became adherent. Stained again to check if anything missing. Then finally tried to make at least the whole margin free from any residual ILM or membrane. The whole margin was round and rolled. Tried to make it raw with cutter in a very low vacuum and pulled to reduce the hole size. Tried to massage the whole margin with the blunt end of cutter from periphery to center around the hole and tried to reduce its size. Masses can be done with macular massager also. This is another case of traumatic macular hole. It seems there was a membrane. Thought it will come with the ILM peeling. But during peeling we found that a layer of sandy deposit is there under the ILM and the retinal layer. And the retinal layers become distorted and fibrosed. According to prior experience, we didn't try much to remove it. and completed the case in a regular way.